Hi everyone, Amy here, and I have an encouragement card to share with you today that came together lightning fast. So let's jump right in. I have the Paradise Found Spa Collection of inks from Catherine Pooler, this gorgeous canopy leaf die from Crafty Meraki, which I have cut out in black, kind of textured, lightweight cardstock, have a 110-pound card base of Nina Classic Crest, and here's a photo of the finished card. Now do stick around to the end. I have a bonus card for you to show you a different way to use these products. But guys, I'm telling you, less than 5 minutes. This came together so fast and I absolutely love how it turned out. So to start, I was just using cool colors. I was thinking I was going to stop there. And then I got a little antsy and wanted to add some purple. Well, then I add the purple and I think, oh no, I just messed this up. So now I got to add a whole rainbow. So I add the orange and then a little bit of red and whew, it saved it. So I like how that looks. So I'm going to stop there. Now I have this die cut from this gorgeous die from Crafty Meraki. And I will link all the products below in the video description box if you want to check any of this out. My affiliate links will be no additional cost to you, but they will help me out with a small commission. So here I have some Artist Tack micro dot sheets. This is how I'm going to apply this really delicate die onto this card base. Now this is a ton of little dots of adhesive on one side and then not on the other side, and you just press it down into it, and I find that it works really well for my little fiddly dies, whether it's sentiments or in this case a floral. So you just have to be really careful pulling it back because it is very delicate, but I'm going to lay it down directly on this card base so it has all this gorgeous color but not a lot of bulk, so it'll be really easy to ship. And I'm just using kind of the outside of the paper because it's kind of smooth, just to burnish it down and help that glue really stick. Now, every once in a while with these micro dots, there will be a transfer of some of the dots onto the front of your die. And on a regular cardstock like this, it's really easy to remove it. If you get it on a metallic cardstock, I have been told that using a little bit of alcohol, maybe on like a Q-tip, will get it off the front of the card. But I find on regular cardstock like this, using my gum eraser or my adhesive eraser like that, takes it off with no problem at all. Now I have this adorable heartfelt stamp set from My Favorite Things, and it has so many encouraging really nice sentiments. And I don't know if it's still available, but if it is, I will link it below in the video description box. But I'm kind of figuring out which one will work best in this space and figuring out where it works in the composition. So I'm just loading it up in my Misty and picking it up with the Misty door. And I am going to stamp it down with a nice dark black pigment ink. It says, I believe in you. Nice and flat. I left the inside open and not stamped, just so there's plenty of room to write to my recipient. And thanks for sticking around. Here is a photo of the second card. I used the outer portion of that die cut and this awesome stitched edge die from LDRS, as well as a sentiment from LDRS Creative. It's a small business in Michigan that I recently discovered. And I used a stencil right on the card base with this cool swag dots from A Colorful Life Designs. And I do have a coupon, so be sure to check that out in the video description box below. But it came together just as quick as the other one, and it was really fun to create these beautiful cards. So I'm happy to send them out. So I hope you enjoyed this. If you did, please hit the thumbs up. And like I said, I will link the products below if you're interested in any of those. And I have a couple other videos for you to check out below. So thanks so much for joining me today. I'll catch you next time. Bye.